In today's video, we will deploy the same Docker container in three different ways. We will deploy it using Portainer, I mean, we will use graphical user interface within Portainer. Then, we will do the same using Docker Compose file. And last but not least, we will use a single Docker run command to do the same. I personally think this is a great method to learn Docker, because you can see that graphical representation first, and then you can create Docker Compose and Docker run commands based on that initial Portainer setup. That way of doing it helped me understand every component of Docker Compose and Docker run command. But you will see what I mean when we go through the process. And for our video, I chose Jellyfin container, but you obviously can use any container you want. But I chose Jellyfin for a reason though. Jellyfin container requires some bind mounts, it will require several network ports to be opened, and some environment variables as well. So I think it might be a great example to show how all of this is configured and how it can be run using those three different approaches. So let's start from installing Portainer, because we will go step by step, starting from scratch today. As I said, there is nothing on this server yet. So let's open the terminal first. And first command I will run is sudo apt update. I need my password. That's done. So the next command I need is sudo apt install docker.io-y. I mean, -y is not needed, but it will simply put yes if installer asks us if we want to proceed or not. Okay, so Docker should be installed. We can now check if it's up and running. Let me clear maybe first. We can run sudo systemctl status docker. Docker is active and running, that's what we need. We can now use our current user to the Docker group. This is optional, but I think it's a good idea to do so. And by the way, all those commands you will find in the comments below this video later on, so don't worry about it. So the command I need is sudo usermod-a G docker, and you can either use current user or you can use environment variable $user, something like that. So basically my user Marek and this environment variable is the same thing. Let's press enter. Now let's pull the image of the Portainer. The command is sudo docker pull, and the image is portainer-ce from the Portainer repo. And we will add the tag latest. Now the pull is complete, so maybe let me clear again. And we can start the Portainer. It's rather long command, so let me just copy-paste it. That's it. And we just press enter. Now the container is up and running, the Portainer container, and it's accessible on port 9000. So I can check what my IP address is. And this is the IP. So I can connect to my Portainer using this address IP and port 9000. Let's open the Firefox. And I need command HTTP IP address colon port. If I now press enter, I will open the Portainer, but it will ask me for the credentials. I have to create a password, and you can see it has to be at least 12 characters long. So we create the user, I can save, and that's it. Our Portainer is up and running. We can click that get started, and if we choose that local environment, we can see one container is running because it's the Portainer itself. So we now can run Jellyfin container. We just click this add container. Now the name can be whatever, let's just call it Jellyfin. The image can be pulled from Jellyfin as well, I believe, but we will pull it from Linux server repo, and the container is Jellyfin. That's it. And as I said, we will need some port mappings. We will add three ports here. 1, 2, 3. First port is 8096, and it's for HTTP user interface of the Jellyfin. And we will keep matching them, the same port on the container as it is on the host. And the port is TCP, which is already selected. Next port I need is 7359, and it's for network discovery of this Jellyfin container, so other devices can see it. And as I said, it's 7359, but it is UDP. So you have to select this UDP. And the last port is 1900. And it's for the LNA client. So if you have, for example, TV or other devices that have the LNA client, you will be able to connect to this Jellyfin container. I mean, the only required one really is the first one, but the other two I always add because that's how I use Jellyfin. I usually use it on my TV. So it's 1900 and it's also UDP port. So only first is TCP and two other ones are UDP. And we can scroll further. There is nothing here on this tab we have to configure. We can switch to volumes. And in those volumes, I will create 3 new volumes, but you might want even more of them. It's up to you. Let's click 3 times this map additional volume. And again. And again. And you can see you can choose volume or bind. And what is the difference? We talked about it in one of the previous videos, and the link to that video should be displayed right now. But basically, volume is a storage that Docker container will manage for you when you run this container. And the bind mount is when you want to bind a location that is already on this host server, on this Ubuntu server. And I will want to use that second option for all of them. I will choose bind for all 3 options. So bind here, and look at how it changes. When I click bind, it changes from volume to path on the host. And the last one also bind. So path on the host. Path in the container and path on the host. We will have to bind them together. The fact is, I haven't created those locations on the host yet. So let's create those folders now, first. Let me just open the terminal again. And I am in home Marek, it's my home directory. So I will just create a folder called Jellyfin with capital letter maybe. That's the new folder. Let me maybe clear first. I will cd to that Jellyfin folder. And let's create 3 more folders. One will be config, another one will be movies, and third one will be shows. Config will be small letter, and movies and shows with capital letter. So if I run lsl, we can see those 3 folders created. So the path is this, home, Marek, Jellyfin, and then config or movies or shows at the end will be here. So let's go back to our container. And on the container, it will be just /config. So directly under the root folder, I will create a folder called config. And I will bind it to this path, to this folder. So maybe copy, easier. /config. The next folder on the container I will create for my movies. And any media directories, they usually go under data or under media folder on the container, and only then you create subfolder. So I will use data maybe. So it's /data/movies. And I will bind this container location to this location on my host. And the last one, I will add some shows as well. Also has to be under data or media on the Jellyfin, and I will call it shows. And again, the host, I called it shows. So yeah, we've got all of those 3 bound from the host to locations on the container. And if you've got like a music or pictures or whatever, you can create simply more folders on the host and bind them the same way to the container. You just map additional volumes. That's it. All right, but for me, these 2 are enough. Let's go to ENV tab, environment, this one. And we will want to add 3 environment variables. So I will click 3 times again. 1, 2, and 3. And the first environment variable is called PUID. It's for process user ID. And in the value, we need a value of 1000. Next environment variable is process group ID, which is PGID in short. And we want the same value, 1000. And the last one, TZ, is for time zone. And well, that depends on where you live. For example, you might have America, Los Angeles, or wherever you are, but for me, it's Europe, London. So that will depend on your location. Now the last thing we need here is to go to that restart policy tab, and we will click that unless stopped down here. That's all settings we need. We just click deploy the container. So let's click it, and let's wait for a while. We can see deployment in progress. It might take a while, but you know, shouldn't be too long. Okay, so that was success. It automatically took us back to that container list page, and we can indeed see Jellyfin up and running. And all those ports that we specified, we can see them listed here. So now I can go to the same IP address of my host, of this Ubuntu host, to this last port 8096, because that's for user interface, and this way I can access my Jellyfin container. So let's do that. We can see the IP was 192.168.1.205. So it's again HTTP 192.168.1.205, but this time it's port 8096. I can access Jellyfin on different port. Let's click enter, and that's our Jellyfin. And I can click next here. We can create a user here as well with some password. If we go next, maybe save, we can click that add media library. If I do that, content type, I have created only for movies and for shows. So let me click the first one, movies. Display name movies, yes, that's fine. And folders, I can find the folder. Oh, you can already see, the Jellyfin shows me. These three folders are available. I don't need config really, because that's the configuration of the Jellyfin itself, but I will pick the movies one. And now the data movies on the container will become my media folder for my movies. Okay. And I know it's empty right now, but if you had something there, it would be displayed here as your movies. And that's the whole process. And that's cool, but what happens if I want to rebuild my Ubuntu server? That would mean I would have to go through all that process again, yes? I would have to install the Docker, I would have to install Portainer, clicking all those options, configure everything. But the fact is, once I know what this container needs and how I want to set it up, I can create a template, and this template is called Docker Compose file. And I can create this container by just taking all the config from that Docker Compose file. Let me show you what I mean. Let's remove that Jellyfin container first. We will build it again using Docker Compose file, but it will be much, much quicker. So let's close this. And here, I just click on Jellyfin, remove. Yes, remove everything. Container successfully removed. We only have now container, and it's the portainer itself. And now let me show you something. We are in Jellyfin, that's fine. We will just create new file. I will call it docker-compose-yaml. And let me paste the code, because it's pretty long. Look at that. Doesn't it look familiar? These are all the options we clicked in the portainer. I mean the name, Jellyfin, that was our first choice. Then the image was Linux server Jellyfin. Then all those ports that I mentioned, DLNA, network discovery, etc. And then our volumes, home Marek Jellyfin config, because this colon is like a separator between what's on our host, the left side is our host, and the right side from the colon is what's gonna be built on our container. This will be again for our movies, and on the container will be data movies, etc. Then our environment variables that we had to set, and the last one was that restart policy, remember? Unless stopped. All that stuff is here, in that one file. So let me just save it, :wq. So this is our file, Docker Compose, and as I said, it will also be included in the comments below the video, so you can have a look. And now I can only run one command, which is docker compose app-d. That d means run in detached mode, run in the background. And it's important that you are in the same location as your Docker Compose file. So now let's just press enter. Oh, okay, so this is fresh install of Ubuntu, so yes, we have to install the Docker Compose first. But as you can see, you've got the command right here, sudo apt install docker compose. So let me just copy-paste it. Yes. Now we have installed Docker Compose, so we just have to rerun the command. Let me maybe clear first again. And as I said, we run a sudo docker compose app-d. That's it. Press enter. And done. Few seconds. And in fact, you will see this container in Portainer as well. Because Portainer is just web-based user interface and you don't have to create containers within Portainer to be able to see them. But when you use Docker Compose files, I mean, you might still want Portainer because it's nice, you know, interface, but you might as well remove Portainer, uninstall it completely, and just use Docker Commons. It's up to you. And if I click that container, if we scroll down, you can see that environments, for example, or if we scroll down to the very bottom, you can see the volumes have been bound the same way we did before, and restart policy is unless stopped. But you might use some terminal commands, like docker ps. Oh, that needs sudo as well. As you can see, you can get the same information basically using docker commands. Maybe as a last test, let's open the browser and let's go to the same URL as before. Oh, it's even browser remembers it. So let's click and Jellyfin is up and running. So if I click again next, set some password. And you may see already movies, partial information is kind of preserved if you run exactly the same container. But you can, for example, add media library. We can add shows as well now, yes? Because we've got shows. And I will add folder shows. It's basically the same thing. And if you click OK, OK. You can see that folder has been added. And that's Docker Compose file. Much easier, much quicker way of creating and running your containers. So now the last method, we can remove it again in Portainer. As we did before, we would click here and remove, but we might instead remove it using a Docker CLI command. So if we go here, Jellyfin container ID is this one. I will just copy it. And the command I need is docker stop and that docker ID. Okay, so that does require sudo still, but never mind. Sudo docker stop and then the container ID. So now if I repeat my previous command, the only container running is now a Portainer, which we can confirm here as well. Ah, but the Portainer shows exited code 0, but it's basically just stopped container. So what you can do in the command line, you can run docker container prune command. This will remove all stopped containers. Okay, if we go back, now it's removed. But if I wanted to run the Jellyfin again, if I want to create the Jellyfin container again, I can just rerun my docker compose up command and I will have Jellyfin up and running again. But I think that's clear. Now quickly the last method, the quickest one. We can also start a container by running just a single docker run command. So let's go to terminal, let's clear it. And let me paste that command. So it is just one line command, but as you can see, you can use backslashes. So each portion is divided, but it still means it is one line command. You could remove these backslashes and run it as one very long command. But again, the information is exactly the same. We set name as Jellyfin. We use image from Linux server Jellyfin, because that's what it is. Docker run, you use name and then use the container ID, and everything that is in between, it's like extra information. For example, these ports we are binding, these volumes we are binding, the environment variables, and then that restart policy. This is just basically one command, and look how quickly it will be built. Let me click enter. Sudo again, sorry. Oh, I clicked up arrow, you can see what it will look like as one command. Let me just add sudo. I probably messed up that very first, one of the very first commands where we should add the current user to a Docker group, but never mind. I will just add sudo. And let's click enter again. That's it. It took probably 3 seconds, not even that. And if we go to Portainer, in 1 second, there it is. Jellyfin, we can see it's running. And I don't want to go through validation again. I hope you believe me that everything looks as it's supposed to. I don't know if you agree, but seeing first build in the Portainer and then seeing those commands, those values, it makes it much easier to understand each of those components. So yeah, that was my point and I hope it helps. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Marek.